You sure know how to drive a hard bargain, Velvet.
What else was I supposed to do? Would you rather I devoured him and swiped all his stuff?
You're more frightening than the Reaper.
Still, that Turtles was an interesting guy.
It's a big world, kid. A lot of strange folks out there.
So I'm discovering.
He probably took one look at us and thought the very same thing.
A demon, a Moloch, and a Reaper. We've got it all.
Ain't that the truth?
What are turtles, anyway?
Some sort of turtle men.
Yeah, but what are they?
They are what they are. All you need to know is that they're good at peddling things.
They're probably just called turtles because they wear all those sea turtle shells on their backs. After all, Rokuro means sixth son, and that's what I am.
I was Teresa's second tethered Malakim, so I was number two.
That's a title, not a name.
Huh?
Would someone just give the kid a name already?
A name? For me?
If you want to live, get out of my way.
Don't get overcome.
See this? What's the best? Bubble! It's a twin light!
I'll cut down anyone in my way!
Come on.
Unarmed? Hardly. These are deadly weapons.
What'll it take?
You better be ready.
Sorry to cut you down.
If you want to live, get out of my way.
On to battle.
Looks like Eifried's first mate has a strange superstition.
It's just a habit. Only comes up tails anyway.
What land did that coin come from? I've never seen a coin with a goddess on one side and the Reaper on the other.
Strictly speaking, that's not the Reaper on the back. It's an image of the Demon King, Douse.
Where have I heard that name before?
Martell the Goddess, and Douse the Demon King. The Book of Ragnarok, Chapter 765. The Battle of Yggdrasil.
Whoa, you're awfully well-read. The coin was dug up from some ancient ruins in another land. They called the place Carlin long ago. It's made from soft, ordinary gold, but they had some process to harden the metal and make it resistant to scratches.
Wow, that's a rather rare find then.
Do you like to read books?
Teresa's chamber was full of them, so I spent a lot of time reading. Ragnarok is a record of battles from the Age of Myth. I've read it several times now.
Anyway, coins like that are hard to come by. Where did you get it?
It's a long story.
Never mind then.
So, were you deciding something with that coin toss?
Not anything I can talk about yet.
Oh, I'm sorry for prying.
Don't waste my time.
Blast!
Your style is really unique.
Just wait until I pull up. There's no guard. Do we just go in?
Wait. This isn't what I expected.
There's a barrier over it?
They changed the security.
You weren't kidding, were you? That scorpion and this barrier, all part of your curse.
You'll be lucky if that's the worst of it.
A direct assault would be a bad idea. What's the plan?
Down the cliff, there should be an entrance used during the fortress's construction. We'll check that.
You did your research.
I had to, didn't I?
Don't get over confidence.
Come on, really?
On to battle!
We're finished here. Let's go. Is that the way in?
This one's actually guarded.
Which means there's no barrier. Let's move, everyone.
Stop! Those guards are...
Careful! They're not what they seem!
You've transformed into demons!
What kind of curse is this, Aizen?
I warned you, didn't I?
You wouldn't expect these guards to carry the demon blight. Is this your curse again?
Probably.
If I'd charged in, that might have turned ugly. Thank you for stopping me.
Don't thank me. He's the one who noticed the danger.
In that case, I'll be counting on you to keep watch. After all, We've got a Reaper with us. Who knows what else we'll find?
Huh?
She's saying it's all right to talk.
Understood. Keeping watch.
Looks like there are demons inside as well. Don't tell me, Aizen. You're the source of demon blight?
Nope. It's just our bad luck to be around when it's spread. This is what it means to walk with the Reaper. You've only yourselves to blame.
It works in our favor. The enemy won't be capable of an organized response.
And we're a small group. Our mobility will be an advantage in the chaos.
So, Aizen, how do we open the sea gate?
The controls ought to be located in the upper part of the gate. We'll activate them and then send a signal.
Got it. To the top of the gate, then.
You better be ready.
Come on, really?
Move it or die. I wish I had power like that. Looks like you want to die.
I'll cut down anyone in my way.
Hey, not all the ships left.
A battleship. Not good.
A fortress with a sea gate that blocks the entire strait. It's crazy what the Abbey can build.
Until recently, I might not have believed it possible.
It's no sweat, if you're using Malakim as tools.
If Malakim can be made a blade to fell demons, they can also be made a hammer to forge metal.
It's another way the Abbey and the Kingdom show their dominance to the people. It says, do not resist, submit.
It's disgusting, is what it is.
Disgusting.
Agreed.
This door should lead to the gate. But it looks like they've got it locked up tight.
Well, brute force is out.
Intruders! How dare you set foot in our domain!
Where's the key?
I am a proud knight of Midgand. I'm not about to yield to the likes of petty demons.
There's nothing I hate more than someone else trying to control the direction of my life. My wheel is mine to hold. If I'm not the one steering the ship, then I'm not truly alive.
The one steering.
Indeed. And my entire life is devoted to the defense of this fortress.
Then you better be ready to accept all that happens to you in the line of duty. Maybe it's time we found out just how deep your devotion truly goes. Take it easy. There's 9 more fingers to go.
Wait! The key is in the control room. Through there!
One more question. Which way to the battleship?
Straight ahead. Up the stairs.
Got it.
Well, thank you for handling that.
It just comes naturally. We need that key. But we also need to take out the battleship before it sails against the Von Eltia.
He's right. The control room or the docks? Which will it be?
Let's start searching.
Okay.
You know, you're pretty good with your fists, Aizen.
Not as good as you are with your swords.
I feel like I've seen a lot of your crew with swords. Do you really never use them yourself?
No. Not with the Reaper's Curse, I don't. It likes to rear its head at the worst times. I've broken blades just by unsheathing them. And once, just as I was about to deliver a finishing blow, my blade separated from the hilt and went flying. That sort of thing. A sword isn't something I can rely upon when my life is at stake. I fight using only my own body. That's one less thing that can go wrong.
It's too bad you're not a swordsman. I bet we could have had a hell of a fight.
I wouldn't need a sword to make it interesting. What do you say? Want to try your sword against my curse?
Sure, if the right time comes. Just don't whine when I end up winning.
You took the words right out of my mouth.
Well, here's where the real show starts. Do we have a plan, First Mate?
The fortress guards are almost all ordinary soldiers. Just a handful of exorcists to deal with.
They went to the trouble to build this huge gate. You'd think they'd keep it better defended.
You don't need an army of exorcists to keep a bunch of disorganized pirates under control, do you?
As long as they're fighting ordinary humans, the Royal Army would suffice.
So a few exorcists as officers is all they need.
It was built as a symbol of the Empire. But it seems Artorias is the one really giving the orders. The Abbey directs security and defense. And Imperial soldiers are under Exorcist command.
We aim for the Exorcists, then. The harder they are, the more fun it'll be.
Ready to bust some heads?
I'd rather cut them, actually.
Finish this quick!
Lovely. A fallen boulder. They're not much for maintenance around here.
Too bad we'd never be able to smash through it. If it weren't for bad luck, we wouldn't have any luck at all.
I suppose.
We still have to get through here somehow. Let's see if we can find some way to move the rock.
You're fighting the Reaper.
Not even worth my time.
How do you plan to stop the battleship?
It's equipped with large cannons. The plan is to use their gunpowder against them.
An exorcist praetor?
The docks are up ahead. Like it or not, we're coming through.
Hey, wait! Are you intruders? I suppose it doesn't matter. I will cut down any who consort with demons. Face the fury of the Rangetsu sword style.
Stand aside, Aizen.
No, you stay back. I'll take care of this one.
Sorry. This prey is mine. Get in my way and I'll kill you too.
Are you mocking the Reaper?
We're running out of time. You folks handle the ship.
Careful, Rokuro. He's...
I know. He's holding back.
Let's go.
Where did you learn the Rangetsu style?
I studied directly under the Legate Shigure of the Abbey.
Lies. He'd never take on a student. Let me guess. He taught you a few things one time when he was super bored, and then crushed you with them.
Is it done, Aizen?
We're set. It also serves as a good signal for the Von Eltia.
Well, that was about the saddest practice I've ever had. But at least I learned where he is. Yo! The Abbey's my goal now, too. Now I can do what I have to do and repay my debt at the same time.
Is that your doing?
What? Is there a problem?
No.
A fine companion for the Reaper.
We have to find that key. Let's get to the control room.
Between your sword style and that giant blade you shoulder, I wonder if you've got Rangetsu blood in you.
I do. What of it?
Have you heard the name Kushiyamada? I hear they're smiths with some connection to House Rangetsu.
Yeah, they're a distant relation, a clan of kitchen knife makers. Why, are you interested in cooking?
No. I just heard they were fine blades. Thought one would make a good gift.
Don't. Kushiyamada knives are cursed.
Hmm?
The blades themselves are excellent, but they give whoever holds one the urge to strike out at anyone and everyone.
I've heard they use the blood of women they love in making their blades, but the truth is a mystery. The clan died out after they all turned on each other. The blades were all supposed to be melted down into slag.
I suppose that's why talk of them is hard to come by these days.
Such is the fate of House Vangetsu. Or maybe it's just in our blood.
Sounds like there's even more to your clan than the rumors say.
Better than there being less, I suppose.
It won't open. It's locked from the inside.
That's a real thick door, too. This must be the control room, right?
That's my guess. We need another way in.
That window would probably work, if it wasn't all barred up.
It looks like a standalone building. Maybe we can find something on one of the other walls.
This seems to be the place. Let's split up and look for the key.
We'll search the other room.
Ah!
Aha! Found it. Don't get so worked up over a little thing like that. It's proof you're alive.
The bump is?
No. I'm talking about the pain.
But I'm scared of pain.
Well, kid, who isn't?
Even you?
Anyway, boys sure are fascinated by the weirdest things.
Fascinated?
You like this, right?
I don't really know. But after I saw one in a book, I got a little curious about it, and I felt...
You felt excited, didn't you?
Yeah. I guess so. Do you know why the needle points north? Who figured out how to make it work? I thought that if I had one of these, maybe I could go on adventures. It's exciting.
When you feel that way, you should talk about it. About what you like and dislike. If you're happy or scared. After all, you're alive.
I'm alive.
That's just my opinion, though. Not an order. Got that?
Understood.
You found it? Now we can get that gate open.
We needed a compass, too. Nice work.
Thank you.
Everything's ready. Let's get our gate on.
What's wrong? Are you not feeling well?
My compass fell on my head and gave me a bump.
Let me take a look. Oh, wow, yeah, that's a big one. Bet that must hurt.
Yeah, but at least I'm still alive.
Are you saying that pain is proof that you're really alive?
That's what Velvet told me.
Well, no worry. I'll just push your bump back down, you'll be good as new.
Wait, what?
I'm just messing with you. Don't sweat it.
Stop fooling around, you two. We have to hurry. Once we get back to the ship, just borrow some sugar and rub it on your bump. It'll make the swelling go down.
Oh, okay.
I promise I won't get mad if you talk.
Okay.
You're awfully fond of that, aren't you? Still, you should keep it in your bag for now.
I'll put it in my bag.
Good. You know, that's a nice bag. It looks made to last.
It's Moritz silk.
I've never heard of Moritz silk.
It's a fine fabric woven from the threads of the Dandarantula spider. It's got a delicate sheen, it's soft as a baby's skin, it's light and stretchable, it breathes, and it's quite durable. But that's not all. Its most fantastic quality is how it absorbs impact.
My, but you're quite the scholar.
Knowledge and experience help you sniff out the best treasure. If you go and stuff every single scrap of plunder you find into your ship, she'll keel over.
That does make sense.
What I'm getting at is, your bag is the best place for you to keep that compass stored.
Keep that thing safe. We need it. All right?
All right.
Finish this quick! You're finished! Let's go!
Your style is really unique.
Thank you.
All right, it's open.
What was that?
It's the Von Eltia telling us they're approaching.
Hurry!
All right. We'll pop the gate open for her. Quickly.
All right. Quickly.
Here I come! Come on, really?
So, this opens the gate.
One side, yes. The gate has two giant doors side by side, with matching levers to open each.
Makes sense.
All right, let's find the other device. And it's open.
Let's meet up with the Von Eltia. Back to the docks.
Can't let you do that. This is my This is my fortress!
Your fighting the Reaper! Hurry, get yourself!
demon blight again.
Ha! I call this an improvement.
The compass.
Windlash!
You won't get away.
Hurricane!
Bubble!
Windlash! Hurricane!
Form
3! Form 2! Hurricane!
The docks are swarming with demons. The Von Eltia will be overrun. Rats, we don't have long.
Aizen, can you signal for them to go through without stopping?
That'd keep them safe. But what about us?
We'll jump down onto it as it goes past.
Huh?
Is there another option? Aizen, give some kind of sign.
There's no need. The Von Eltia will sail through.
Without an order?
It was part of my plan. Welcome to the Eifried Way.
It's coming at full speed!
Let's get a move on then.
Will this really work?
Do you want the Reaper's reassurance?
Wait, what are you? Like that.
I'm sorry. Yes! Nailed it! You're lucky Mommy Lou's around!
Let's go.
Ah!
Nicely done!
You're not going to thank your savior for her crafty cannonballing?
Are you nuts? I told you to stay away from the cannons, not bang on them.
But it was fun! And everything worked out, right? I'm sorry.
If it's that important to you, keep it safe. You wouldn't want to lose it again.
Give it. I need to set a course. Fine. You read it for me then.
Yeah.
But listen, kid. Give me one false reading and you're shark bait.
Better work hard.
What's Luffy said?
It's a name. Your name.
My name? Luffy said.
It's a fine name.
Well, it's no Mogilu.
We're through the channel. Give us a course, Luffy said.
Aye, aye, sir. We're headed straight for Logres.
Now this is refreshing. Sailing into port like normal people.
Well done, boy. The sharks are gonna go hungry tonight. Yes, I'm glad.
This won't be a problem, docking a pirate ship here.
So, how were the northern seas, Aizen?
Helavis and Vortigern are in ruins. Trade with Northgand will likely be disrupted for quite some time.
Well, I like the sound of that. I'll have to act quickly.
Any word of the captain?
Aye. It's an old rumor. But they say Captain Ifrid was sent to Titania.
The island prison overseen by the Exorcists, huh? We'll have to look into that.
I registered your vessel as one of our merchantmen, same as always. But even so, stay on guard. There's a grand ceremony being held in Logres. Lots of watchful eyes about.
I see. So they exchange information for mooring.
Information? For mooring?
Having the latest news gives merchants a chance to make favorable trades.
So it's worth protecting a pirate.
I bet Aizen and his crew have connections like this in nearly every port.
Not even the Abbey's iron decrees can withstand the force known as human greed. I see.
Don't bother going to Titania. You won't find Ifrid there.
And how do you know that?
Because I escaped from there. And before I did, I heard something from the prisoners. They said Ifrid was the only prisoner to ever get out alive, and that he was taken by an old exorcist named Melchior.
Lord Melchior is an elder legate at the Abbey. He should always be present at the headquarters.
Don't call him Lord.
Von Ifrid's our captain. It's starting to look like his disappearance has connections with the highest levels of the Abbey.
Their headquarters should be in the capital, right?
Yes, at the Royal Villa in Logres. I've never been there, though.
And Velvet, your business is with a man in the capital, right?
Looks like we're all headed to the same place.
I won't apologize for involving you.
Usually I'm the one who says that. By the way, there's the little matter of your ship. My men brought her through the gate as well. We're going to use her as a scouting vessel.
Do what you want. We stole it in the first place.
A scouting vessel?
I've assigned Benwick to her. He'll give you the details.
Wind's kicking and the tide's flowing, and we're stuck here.
Then why not just set sail?
Not going to happen. The Abbey hasn't given us permission yet.
And we would need their permission, why?
The Kingdom keeps a strict watch on harbors and sea routes. It's like they've erected walls and gates in the sea.
Aha! Midgand is spread across a number of islands. The sea is the only way to get from one place to another. If they can control the ships, they can control the flow of people, goods, and even information.
Exactly. They even created that fortress, Vortigern, to help them do just that.
It's restrictive, but it's also necessary. Demons are out at sea too, and exorcists are the only ones who can stand against them.
Even still, it rubs me the wrong way. A sea dog obeys nothing but the winds and the waves.
Crabs are amazing, right?
Oh yeah! They're delicious, boiled or grilled! Even their innards are yummy! And five sets of legs, that's so many!
That's all true, but what really makes them amazing is their miraculous ability to regenerate. They can detach their own legs when a predator attacks, which lets them get away.
It's called autotomy.
And then, not long after they detach their leg, a new one grows from the stump.
Really? So you're saying we need to catch lots of crabs, then scare them so they detach their own legs?
That's exactly what I'm saying, bro. We can harvest as much as we like. No one's thought of this before. We're geniuses.
Huh. I never knew that. I thought only lizards could regrow a lost body part, and only their tails.
Lizards? Do you think Dial's tail can grow back?
If it does, we could make a killing by selling Dial tails.
Would they be tasty?
No idea.
Ugh, no way.
Have you heard? Marcus and his pirates were taken out by the Royal Navy.
So, they even got Marcus's crew now.
Of the four pirate kings who terrorized Midgand, only Ifrit and his crew remain.
Aren't the seas still swarming with pirates?
Only small fry that rob small civilian ships on the sly. But the only pirates left that can pick a fight with the Royal Navy and win are Ifrit and his crew.
In other words, the only ship left that's truly free is the Von Eltia.
For a merchant, you really seem to like these pirates.
He may be crooked, but money's not all he's after. If profit was his only desire,
He could have made more by selling us out.
But that'd be too boring, don't you think? The fun's in making a killing by breaking the rules.
You're a funny guy.
And that's why Ifrit goes through him whenever we need to dock here.
Well, I can't say I've ever met a human like him.
I've heard there's a prison island somewhere where they keep the worst of the worst, but it's a hard tale to swallow.
It's true.
And the rumors that hundreds of demons are imprisoned there?
Fact.
People say that no one has ever escaped from there alive.
That one's a lie. After all, we're here.
Wait, you don't mean...
Keep your mouth shut. Otherwise, you'll fare worse than anyone on that island.
Yes, sir. I didn't hear a thing.
Thank you. Thank you.